guys, welcome back. So I got this, made this little thing right here. Or little, I don't know how little it is. It's pretty big compared to my hands and everything. But you probably saw the title, so you probably know what it is. Unless you didn't read the title and just clicked on the video. But I'm pretty sure you'd read the title before clicking on a video. But this is a top right here. And so this is a top spinner. So it spins the top for you. Now, everybody right now is probably thinking, just spin it yourself, like you can spin it, right? Well, you can. So the point of this machine, it can spin the top for you, so you don't have to. You don't have to like move your fingers like this if you're too lazy to. The machine can do it for you, and it looks way cooler when the machine does it. So, you know, if your hands do this, it's kind of boring to watch. But when the machine does it, it's really interesting. So you guys got to stay tuned to watch this thing work. But yeah, let me show you the closer up. So the filming table, it's slanted a certain direction, so I have to like turn it around a certain direction. It's kind of dumb. It kind of sucks having it like that. This came undone. Okay, there we go. This is poked out, which it shouldn't be. That's just me showing it. It should be lined up in there, like how it is right now. So it should be in there, and then this top piece, it just slides into that hole like that. You can kind of see how the axle just sits in there, and then when this goes out, you let go, and it grabs it, so like that, and it spins it. Okay, so the top is made from a tire from one of the motorcycle sets. It's a red one, I think. It's a Ducati, I think. It's red Ducati, and then this is the back tire of it. It's a really thick tire. But it causes a lot of, it's really heavy, which makes the top spin for a long time. But the rest of the top, it's like a 1x5 axle connected to a 1x6 axle. I don't have a 11 axle. I don't know if they make them, but I don't have an 11 axle, so I just combine them with that piece. This little piece right here is what, the machine holds it up with and spins it, and then drops it from that. So that's what that piece is, and then the gear, of course, to spin it. But that's what the top is made out of. Okay, guys, so let me show you this working. So I'll just put this in here, and then go. Hey, torquing, you see? That's how it works. The closer it gets, moves by the back, oh goodness. There you guys go. What it's doing. Okay, so as you guys saw in the last clip, that was it working, so it like slowly moves back as this gets closer. So if I run the code real quick without it in, if I go like this, you can kind of see how it works. So this slowly moves back and it goes like that. So every time it senses, it moves much back a certain amount. Like, I could make it so it does more, but I feel like it looks cooler when it just goes slightly. I don't know. I think it looks cooler when it goes slightly, but it could do a lot, but like how far back it moves, but I think it's cool when it just does it slightly. So that's what it does. It pretty much spins the top, and it spins it pretty fast too. Okay, guys, so the one problem with this that, well, I guess there's probably a couple problems, but I don't know. The one main problem, everything else works fine pretty much, is when this turns and it goes, it drops it, and then this moves around the sensor and hits the side. That's like the main problem, and I don't have like two other sensors to put on the sides, so it's like I can't really fix it, but that's the one problem. So sometimes it doesn't work, so let's see what it does this time. Okay, this time it's working. But sometimes it'll move around the sensor and not work. But this time, it's working as it should. Okay guys, so I'm gonna time to see how long it can spin the top for. So I put this in there. Sometimes it can just hold itself up, but it's not working right now. But sometimes it'll just stay in there. But then we go like this. Make sure it touches the ground, I'll try to move this out of the way. It almost failed. Okay, so it lasted for about like almost exactly 1 minute. So about a minute long was that roll. So well, that spin. So that was pretty good. A minute is how long you can spin for, which I don't think I could do that with my hand. Spin for it for a minute. But yeah, that's how long it took.
Okay, guys. So this is the code right here for the top spinner. So this is what the code looks like. You can see at the start, both of these right here, they both go start at the same time. So on the first one, it waits a second, and then it the motor in port A runs for 2 seconds, which that would be this motor. So if you're wondering, it's the one that spins the top, that one. That's motor. So that's what this track does. And then this one right here, motor B, it is the one that triggers this mechanism. You can see right there moving. It's that one. And that one was 180 degrees right here. And then it waits 2 seconds and then spins back 180 degrees. And then this motor, the very back one, as soon as it drops the top, the wheels spin 0.5 rotations, and then this loop right here, it's every time this sees the top within its range, it spins 0.2 rotations. So that's what the code looks like.
Okay guys, so it's it for the video. This was the Lego top spinner that I made with my Mindstorms. If you want to check out my other Mindstorms builds, I'll have a card up here in the corner for the playlist of all of them. And also, it'll be linked down in the description. But as always, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notifications bell.